Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the first video on working with TimelineFX setups in the Flame 2021.1 products, I introduced the workflows and showed you how to create and apply TimelineFX setups in combination with the Explorer. They are all quick and intuitive methods, but in order to keep your growing TimelineFX setups under control, we do recommend organizing and filtering your setups where necessary. So we'll dig deep into the Explorer to help you manage and understand what you see, and then we'll move on to filtering, which will be an invaluable tool in the effects environment, regardless of the type of production and the workflows you are using. This training is not footage specific, so please use your own media to follow along. So continuing on from the previous video, the Explorer has a variety of TimelineFX setups and folders. In terms of organization, the Explorer pretty much matches the functionality of the media panel. So you can cut, copy, paste and duplicate using the context and gear menu, and you can manually reorder the TimelineFX setups in any way you choose simply by dragging them around the Explorer. Now, similar to the media panel, you can toggle the display between the tiles and list view. The thumbnails can be resized to have more or less setups visible, but any naming, timecodes, TimelineFX icons and thumbnail previews will always be on display. As a tip, if you didn't want any metadata covering the thumbnails, just disable the information via the gear menu. Now, if you need more room for the Explorer in the interface, the panel is resizable by dragging the vertical bar. Switching to the list view, you get a different representation of the TimelineFX setups, but the information is equally useful. The metadata of the TimelineFX setups are laid out in columns. So by default, you have one column for the main structure with resizable previews, and the second column showing what TimelineFX are present in each TimelineFX setup. If you call up the context menu over the column headers, you can add more columns to the Explorer, as well as sort the TimelineFX setups in a number of ways. So even though the Explorer works with TimelineFX setups and reference stills, you can manage everything in a very organized manner. As a reminder, the two differences between clips and TimelineFX setups is that the TimelineFX setups do not contain media and can also exist without a name. Now, over time, it is very possible that you can build quite a large selection of TimelineFX setups. You might be building a grade bin with overall looks or looks per shot. You could also be experimenting with multiple VFX setups to choose the best one for your client. Whatever you are doing, you need to be able to filter the information to quickly get to the specific TimelineFX setups. So within the Explorer, you have criteria-based filtering. This applies to TimelineFX setups as well as reference stills. Just click the filter button or press space E. When no options are selected, the Explorer panel remains the same. Essentially, you need to define the criteria and the Explorer will automatically display your results. You can filter by TimelineFX, name, segment, shot name, color, and a flame user profile. To make this more useful to you, let's look at a couple of scenarios where you would use filtering. The first case is if you only want to see the TimelineFX setups created from the current segment. So you would enable segment and choose current. The Explorer updates, and if you want to hide the filtering window, just click the double arrow next to the filter button. Even though the filter window is hidden, you are still informed that the Explorer is being filtered by segment. So these TimelineFX setups were created with this segment in the sequence. If you move over to other thumbnails in the storyboard reel, the Explorer will update with any TimelineFX setups that were created with that segment. This is great for tracking the development of a particular shot without having to scroll through all the other TimelineFX setups. This could easily be used for both VFX and grading workflows. Now, if you need to use this filter often, you can save it as a filtering preset. Click the arrow next to the filter button and add a new filter preset. Call it Current Segment. So the next time you want to use these specific filter settings, just choose your filter preset. You can add and delete them as you see fit. Moving on, another use case is if you want to find all the TimelineFX setups using a particular TimelineFX. So going back to the filtering window and make sure you turn off any of the previous options. Click the TimelineFX pull-down menu and I'll choose the image TimelineFX. So every setup in the Explorer that contains an image TimelineFX will be filtered. You can also filter by multiple TimelineFX if you want. Go back to the TimelineFX pull-down menu and I'll choose the Matchbox TimelineFX. So any TimelineFX setup containing one or all of these TimelineFX will be displayed in the Explorer. If you want to filter this down further, you can switch the TimelineFX filtering from any to all, and only the TimelineFX setups containing both TimelineFX will be displayed. So this allows you to be loose or strict with TimelineFX filtering. As before, let's save this filter as a preset. I'll call mine Image plus Matchbox. So even without the filtering window visible, you can toggle between your filtering TimelineFX setups, making it quick and easy to work with. The final scenario I'd like to cover with filtering is more custom metadata driven. In other words, when you create a TimelineFX setup, it has loads of associated metadata that you can filter, but you can also add a bit more. For example, you can select a TimelineFX setup or a multi-selection and color code them via the context menu. Now open the filter window and clear out any of the previous settings. As a tip, when it comes to the TimelineFX filter, you can reset the whole selection without having to uncheck each TimelineFX. Now enable color, and you can choose whichever color you're filtering with. You can save this as a filtering preset if you choose, but the point I'd like to make is that you can combine any of the filtering criteria to make a very specific filter to isolate the shots you're looking for. Now, one last tip I'd like to share with regards to filtering is that if you'd like to create a TimelineFX setup while filtering is enabled, it is possible, but with two potential scenarios. If the new TimelineFX setup matches the filtering criteria, then the filtering will remain active. However, if the new TimelineFX setup does not match the filtering criteria, filtering will turn off in order for the setup to be visible upon creation. So you can see exactly where the TimelineFX setup will be placed, and then you can turn filtering back on if you choose to. So that covers organizing and filtering your TimelineFX setups to work smarter. In the next video, you'll carry on creating and applying TimelineFX, but this time, you'll learn how to create TimelineFX setups that are specifically focused on the selectives, which are found in the image and action toolsets. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2021.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel and click the bell to be notified for future videos. Thanks for watching and hope to see you soon.